Okay, so let's look at current equations. So I'm considering n-type EMOS. Okay, so just have a drain characteristics and transfer characteristics in your head. Visualize them. Okay, so this is the drain characteristics. ID versus VDS. ID versus VDS, and for a constant value of VGS, so throughout this curve, VGS is constant, some positive value since it is enhancement type MOSFET. There are certain regions which I marked in blue. When the value of VDS is very very small in this region, then it is called as linear. It is working in linear mode. MOSFET is working, your EMOS, N-type EMOS is working in linear mode. If it is in this region where VDS value will be slightly greater than slightly more, then you call it as triode region. And if you go beyond this value, edge of saturation, this is the point, edge of saturation where VDS value is VGS minus VT, if you go beyond this, your MOSFET will be working in saturation region. Okay, saturation, triode, linear. If you are in saturation region, means your VDS value will be either equal to or greater than VGS minus VT. IDS value will be equal to, IDS means drain to source. Drain to source current is equal to mu n COX W by 2L VGS minus VT whole square. Where what is VT? VT is your VGS cutoff. Okay, or you call it as threshold value. Usually be represented by VT, okay, VGS cutoff, which will be positive for enhancement type MOSFET, N-type, okay. So that is what VT means. This is a constant term which I will discuss later. Mu n is mobility, COX is oxide capacitance, W is width of the channel, and L is length of the channel. Okay, so these all are constant and will be given to you in the questions. Okay, so this will be the current equation followed by the MOSFET when VDS will be greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. If VDS is less than VGS minus VT, this is the current equation followed by the MOSFET. ID will be equal to mu COX W divided by 2L into 2 VGS minus VT, VDS minus VDS whole square. Okay, so here VDS is coming into picture, here VDS is not there. Okay, this is very important. Right now we are in triode region. Okay, this equation satisfied this region. When VDS will be very very less than VGS minus VT, means if you are in this region, your MOSFET will act as a resistor, linear resistor. Okay, and the current equation will be this. So assume that VDS is very very less than VGS minus VT in this region, so VDS square will be even less. Okay, VDS square will be even less because VDS is very very less than VGS minus VT. So VDS square will be very very less than VGS minus VT, even lesser, because if you have a 0.1 value of VDS, if you will take square of this, it will come 0.01. so it is even more, even less than what we had before. Okay, so that is what I mean. So hence that's the reason we are ignoring this term VDS square, and you get this equation, the remaining part. Okay, mu COX W divided by 2L, 2 VGS minus VT VDS. Okay, and if you want to find the resistance value, then you do del ID divided by del VDS, differentiate this with respect to VDS. So this term will be mu and COX W divided by 2 will get cancelled, VGS minus VT will be remaining, and we have differentiated with respect to VDS. Okay, rest of the term is constant. So it is as it is, 2 and 2 get cancelled. Now del ID divided by del VDS is called as 1 by RON. Okay, so differentiation is with respect to current divided by with respect to voltage. You can see current divided by voltage, so 1 divided by RON. Okay, instead of RON, you have 1 divided by RON, because it is current divided by voltage, not voltage divided by current. So 1 divided by RON. So if you take inverse, you will have RON is equal to 1 divided by this whole quantity, mu n COX W divided by L VGS minus VT. Okay, so this is the value of RON. Means if you are in this region, your MOSFET will behave as a resistor, on resistor, which will, whose value will be this 1 divided by mu n COX W divided by L VGS minus VT. Okay, so this is one important point, this is one important point, and this is one important point. Okay, so depending upon the value of VDS, where it is lying, your MOSFET will behave different. Okay, yeah, it will follow different equation of currents. So first you always check in which region it is working. Either it is working in saturation, then you apply this formula. If it is working in triode region, then you apply this formula. This formula will work in linear region also, but it is VDS value will be very very less than VGS minus VT. So if you want to find the current in this region, then you follow this equation. Okay, means you neglect the value of VDS square. Just you have to do that. And then if you want to find the resistance value which it will represent, MOSFET will represent, then 1 divided by this quantity. Okay, threshold value will be positive, VGS value will also be positive because you are enhancement type. Positive value of cutoff voltage as well as VGS value is also positive. VDS value will be also positive in this case also. Okay, you can see that. So I hope you are able to imagine everything by the help of characteristic curves. Okay, drain characteristics, transfer characteristics, everything should be clear by now, so that you can follow this. And I will talk about this constant. Plus I am not getting into the proof of how these equations are coming, because I don't think it is necessary, because mostly we use this current equation, we don't go for how it is coming. So that's why I am skipping that part, the proof of this current equation, the proof of this current equation, why this equation is valid when VDS is less than VGS minus VT, why this equation is valid when VDS is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. All this I am skipping because it is not necessary, I believe. We should know how to use this current equation, when to use it. That is more important. That's why I am skipping it. Okay, we will look at P-types as well, P-type enhancement MOSFETs and depletion MOSFETs, what will be the current changes and voltage changes. We will see all that. Okay, so this is for N-type EMOS. Okay, so let's look at the depletion type of MOSFET, N-type. So the drain characteristics will be as it is, the equations will be as it is. Now what will happen, VGS value can be positive as well as negative. Okay, and the threshold value will be negative. So if you remember the curve for depletion type, we had N-type depletion MOSFET, we had curve like this. Okay, this was the transfer characteristics. So VGS can be negative, VGS can be positive. That's the reason VGS can be positive and negative. Here also it can be positive or negative, positive negative, positive negative, positive negative, it depends. Okay, where it is working. And plus the threshold voltage will be negative. This is the threshold voltage, okay, or VGS cutoff or VT. So it will be a negative value. Okay, this is the 0 point. So negative value will be there in threshold. So this will be negative, this will be negative. So negative negative become plus, negative negative become plus, negative negative plus. So that's how things will change. Okay, so just remember this curve and apply the value of the quantities VGS VT according to this curve. Okay, where it is lying. If it is depletion MOSFET, you don't know what will be the VGS value. Either it can be positive or either it can be negative. But in enhancement MOSFET N-type, you know that it will be always positive, VGS and VT. Okay, here VT will be always negative. This is what you can extract. Okay, it will be always negative. VGS can be either negative or either positive. Okay, so this will be minus minus plus plus plus, and VGS value can be positive or negative. So that's the only difference. Everything will be remain similar to what we have till now seen. Okay, even these values, all this will satisfy. Only you have inbuilt channel now, and your VGS value can be positive, negative, and with threshold value will be negative instead of positive in deep depletion MOSFET N-type. Now we will look for P-type. Okay. Okay, so now let's look at the P-type enhancement MOSFET. So we have transfer characteristics like this, we have drain characteristic like this. We are taking one curve only for some constant value of VGS, let's say minus 2 volt. Okay, this will be the curve and this is how the regions will be separated now. ID versus VDS, VDS is in negative direction. This is the linear region, this is the triode region, this is the saturation region. And this point is edge of saturation, which is VGS minus VT. Now mind you, the threshold value will be negative here, sine wise. VGS value will be also negative, okay, because you will take VGS value somewhere here and VDS value is also negative, okay. We are talking about VDS, VGS, okay, and not VSD or not VSG. VDS and VGS, negative values in this direction. Threshold voltage will be negative. So everything will be same. Now the condition will change. You can see if VDS is more negative than VGS minus VT, then you have saturation. Hence, if VDS is less than equal to VGS minus VT, means if VDS is in this direction somewhere here, or it is equal to VGS minus VT, you will have saturation. Now the current will go from source to drain rather than drain to source. Okay, we have seen why. So source to drain it will go mu and cox, this will be mu p, okay, this will be mu p cox, so here also it will be mu p, so everywhere it will be mu p since it is a p type, okay, mu p. So that is the one difference, mu p will be there. VGS will be negative, VT will be negative, so negative negative will be plus and VT will be greater than some value of VGS, so overall quantity will be positive. Whole square will not matter, but the current will go from source to drain. Similarly, here if you will see this region, triode region, means VDS value will be greater than, in this direction you are going, so greater than VGS minus VT, then you have triode region. ID is equal to mu P COX W divided by 2L. 2 VGS minus VT, VDS minus VDS square. Okay, VDS is negative, VGS is negative. If you have VDS greater, very very greater than VGS minus VT, which you are, if you are in this region, then MOSFET will act as resistor. Okay, the value will be same. Mu P COX W divided by 2L, 2 VGS minus VT, VDS, and everything will be same. Here also, if you are wondering about the value of RON will get negative, then it will not, because VGS will be again some negative value, VT will be negative value, but VT negative value, negative negative plus, this is minus, this is plus, VT value is greater than VGS, some value of VGS, so overall quantity will be plus, okay, so resistance will be plus only. So that is how you imagine by looking at the drain and transfer characteristics, that what should be the value of VT, VGS, VDS and all, okay, that will give you a clear picture of how whenever you solve the problems, you will get a clear picture of what should be the value, either should be positive or either it should be negative. Sometimes people get confused in p-type, solving p-type of questions, okay. So this is for enhancement MOSFET. Now we will look for depletion type. So again, in this video only I will write it. So for depletion type, here I will write D. Depletion type means you can have positive as well as negative value of VGS. So this will be the, somehow like this will be the curve. This will be threshold. This is VGS, this is ID, this is transfer characteristics, this is drain characteristics. Now the VGS value can be positive or negative, both it can be. The curve will look like this, similar, everything will be similar. Now the threshold voltage will be positive, okay, rest all the situation will be same, okay, only the polarity of VGS changed. VGS can be positive or it can be negative. VT will be positive, always positive. This is depletion type, okay, p-type depletion type MOSFET. And the curve will go like this. It can go positive, it can go negative VGS value. If it is positive above, negative it is below. Okay. So that is how the you can visualize everything, current equations and all. Now we will look for problems. When we will solve problems, we will convert n type to p type to n type and then solve it, then convert it back to p type. This kind of approach we will see, so that it will get easier, so that it will be very, very easy to visualize the answers. Okay, now let's go for the problems. Okay, so there is one more condition you have to make sure, which usually people neglect. So we have these transfer characteristics till now we have seen. ID versus VGS, ID versus VGS, ID versus VGS, ID versus VGS. Okay, so these are of depletion type, these are for enhancement type. N-type, P-type, N-type, P-type. Okay, so you can see here one thing, that if your VGS value will be not enough, if it is not greater than or equal to the threshold value, your channel will not be formed. When we were discussing this enhancement and depletion type, we saw that there is a certain amount of value of VGS is required so that you can have current. Okay, so just onto that point, we have to satisfy always that your VGS value is greater than equal to V threshold. Okay, VGS value will be less than equal to VTH. Here VTH will be negative, so VGS has to be in this direction so that channel is formed. Else channel will not be there, then what will happen? It will not provide any current. Okay, source will not be able to emit and drain will not be able to collect, or other way around. Similarly, in depletion type, when you go beyond threshold voltage, if you will take VGS value greater than VTH, then your current will be zero. It is as if your channel, whatever was present in the depletion type, was also got depleted. Okay, so it has eaten out the already present channel. That is what you can think if you will go beyond VGS value. Hence, you have to keep VGS value less than equal to VT, means in this direction. Okay, similarly here also, you have to keep the value of VGS greater than VTH threshold. Here VTH is negative, VGS can be positive or negative, but it has to be greater than threshold value. Okay, so if these conditions are not satisfied, means channel is not formed, means ID will be zero, or it is called as cutoff region. Okay, so in drain characteristics you can see this will provide a nanoampere of current. This is how the current will diagram will look like. This is how the current diagram will look like. So this is VGS constant, VGS constant. Current, you can see, it is of nanoampere level. The amplitude will be of nanoampere, which is almost, you can think of it as a current equal to zero. Okay, so this is how the drain characteristics will look like. These are transfer characteristics and the condition you have to satisfy. So along with all the condition which you saw previously, along with that you have to make sure that your VGS value is less than or greater than threshold value. Else channel will not be formed, and hence you will have current equal to zero, which is called as cutoff region as well. Okay, so this is one extra condition you have to make sure.